I became a running sick baby.
What does it take for a good roster?
I think you have to find the bizarre, you have to find the kind of humanity of it. You have to find, in a way, the sympathy of it. Because I think there's nothing more boring than a kind of straightforward villain who just wants to do evil. Actually, what you have to find is the kind of mitigating factors. You have to find the sympathies and the complexities within the character to make them interesting. For example, the character of Rosanna in Vampires of Venice, her whole motivation was actually quite arguably benign. She just wanted a very small piece of the earth to save her entire race. So, and that means that her motivation is complex and not simple and not just pure evil. And I think that's the secret of it.
Which is kind of the way the Doctor investigates as well, isn't it? He never approaches the monster with the intention of killing it. He wants to know what it is and why, and he's excited by
what
its motivation is.
Because the Doctor Who is essentially a detective story every week, and they arrive, there is a problem, there is something going on, he then has to find out what has led them to this point. And so understanding the kind of the intention and is a big part of that sort of investigative process.
Presumably though, in the coming episodes maybe get some resolution to the whole astronaut kills the Doctor. Seems like an issue that could come up.
I imagine they'll probably address that at some point. I genuinely don't know, because the thing is, the one downside of working on Doctor Who is that you inevitably learn a lot of stuff that's going to happen. I knew months and months, probably before Matt Cameron, who Riverstone was, because there's a specific line in God Complex that I needed to know the information to write the sign. And it's the one kind of thing is that because I want to be watching it like you guys. I want to be watching it with my kids and enjoying it. I deliberately don't know how the series ends because I love the show as a viewer as well as a contributor.
What is brilliant for Stephen is that he will tell you the things that you need to know, but he takes so much pleasure in holding back. And
he's really neat like that, man. I've got to say.
The amount of times he's told us. A desert in Utah, brilliant, go and get that location, take your cameras out there, take a cast, and then we get the page and go, oh my god, what's he done? This is not, he just loves curveballs, and actually we love them too, because it means we're constantly surprised.
And so, Matt, when do we get to see the new ones?
Well, actually, I think the next episode is 27th of August on BBC America. 9, 8 Central, I think that's right. 9, 8 Central, that's right, thank you very much. Thank you. In the front row.
They don't have Central where you guys come from.
No, they're just great genius time, I think it is. I have no clue what I'm talking about. Are we showing things?
Yeah, but what I want to do there, I suspect there may be some questions at some point.
Indeed.
Before we do that, let's show a little bit of what maybe is coming up.
Yeah. Okay. Let's see what's coming up.